we've done episode 1, 2, and 3, where we rescued, or at least tried to rescue Doc from a dystopian society which apparently he and his wife created, a moral, strict, and big brother type 1984-ish society. Anyway, things didn't go according to plan, and Edna has now taken both Marty and her husband Doc Brown to a facility to undergo behavioral readjustment. So, I believe this is, yes, it is the second last episode.
What? Where am I? Ah, Citizen Plus?
Citizen Plus?
Yes. Well, let's look at our options here.
That's not very relaxing.
Make sure the McFly boy is prepped for his Citizen Plus treatment by the time I finish with my husband.
How is Citizen Brown?
I'm afraid it's worse than we imagined. He's gone completely antisocial.
Darn.
We're using every tool at our disposal to snap him out of it. But I fear that nothing short of a complete personality rebuild will bring our leader back to us.
And it's all McFly's fault?
Unbelievable, isn't it? One teenage hooligan has brought Hill Valley to the brink of ruin. Ah, well. Let me know when he's ready. I'll be tending to Citizen Brown.
I gotta get out of here and rescue Doc.
Could at least ask for some breakfast first. Maybe some eggy wigs. Notice that Clockwork Orange reference? Looked like they've done that to poor old Doc Brown there too, with the eyes pinned open. What's my guitar doing in here?
Someone's locked up all my stuff. I'll never get that combination on my own.
Yeah, no way you could just pick up that flower pot and just smash your way into there. This is a video game, after all.
Hello?
What?
Let me out of here!
Sorry, sir, but Citizen Plus patients aren't allowed to exit their waiting rooms until the Citizen Plus treatment chamber has been suitably prepped for their procedure.
That's a nice accent he's got there.
You can't keep me in here. It's against the law.
When you sign your Citizen Plus treatment agreement, you gave the Citizen Plus ward legal approval to incarcerate you until the completion of your Citizen Plus treatment.
I don't remember signing anything.
I didn't sign anything.
Of course you did, sir. Citizen Edna handed me the paperwork herself.
Of course she did. I don't suppose you believe me if I told you that Edna forged my signature?
That's a good one, sir.
I thought it was pretty good, too.
Hey, could you get me a burger or something? The only food I've had today is a tofu dog.
Regrettably, sir, the rigors of the Citizen Plus treatment require you to begin the process with an empty stomach.
Why is all my stuff locked in a cage?
In order to ensure that Citizen Plus patients don't injure themselves, their belongings are placed in a locked box until the completion of their Citizen Plus treatment.
Injure themselves?
It's a very intensive process. Some people can't handle it.
Can I take a look at my stuff for a second?
Why?
I want to make sure my guitar neck isn't getting bent.
What?
Come on, man. My parents spent a fortune on that thing.
Fine. Back away from the door, sir.
Oh, we could just take him out?
There. How's the guitar?
I guess it's okay.
Good.
Sound like Forrest Gump. Guitar. Why are there two talk boxes?
Martin?
Ah, Dad, is that you?
Who else would it be?
Where are you?
Back in the garage. What are you doing in the Citizen Plus ward?
Edna threw me in here.
Do that to my son. How can I help?
Not that I'm not happy that you're here, but why are you here?
I'm looking for your mother.
Mom?
After you left, she and I had a big old fight, and, well, she went and signed herself up for a full battery of Citizen Plus treatments.
Didn't you tell her about Biff?
I tried. You know your mother. Once she puts her mind to something, she's a regular force of nature.
I figure that if I can just find her, maybe I can talk her out of this foolishness.
George McFly, everybody. Once a peeping Tom, always a peeping Tom.
So, have you found Mom yet?
Not yet.
You wouldn't believe how many cameras they've got around here.
See? Told ya.
It's nice that you're concerned about Mom, but couldn't you come down here yourself?
Oh, I couldn't do that. I'm probably in enough trouble with the authorities already.
No, I think it's better for everyone if I stay here in my garage with my televisions and cameras.
Is there any way you could help me escape this loony bin?
What did you have in mind?
I don't know. Maybe override the security systems or something.
Override the what? Son, this isn't a science fiction movie.
Is there any way you could help me escape this loony bin?
What did you have in mind?
I don't know. Maybe override the security systems or something.
Override the what? Son, this isn't a science fiction movie.
Dad, those Citizen Plus watches are going to turn everyone in Hill Valley into robots, starting with Citizen Brown.
I always suspected digital watches were evil.
It's not the watches, Dad. It's Edna. She's completely lost it.
Citizen Edna's crazy? Oh, that's not good. Although it would explain a lot.
I have a digital watch, and I'm not evil.
Dad, I know this is a lot to accept, but I've got to rescue Citizen Brown so that we can go back in time and stop him from ever marrying Edna in the first place.
You're right, son. That is a lot to accept. So let's... Forget you ever said it. Just concentrate on getting you out of there.
Yeah, maybe that's for the best.
I thought he'd believe us.
I tried to peek over the guard's shoulder to get the combination, but he's too tall.
Over his shoulder? Hold on.
What?
I may have it on tape.
Zoom, enhance. Zoom, enhance. Ha!
What?
The camera was high enough to see over his shoulder.
Nice work, Dad.
The combination is... 2 left, 8 right, 18 left, 32 right.
All right.
Hey, your guitar. I'm sorry I tried to throw it out.
Yeah, the guitar's pretty cool, but this is what I care about.
No fair making your dad all misty, son.
Okay, I got two problems. How was he able to see the combination and not his guitar? And how is he able to see the combination? I mean, look, here I am, where my hand is. I don't know, I don't think that camera's that good.
Dad!
How can I help, son?
Stay close, Dad.
I'm as close as I can get, Martin.
Name's Marty. Did we get everything out of that? Yes. Alright, let's have a look at that inventory.
I hope the other me forgives me for stealing his guitar. On the other hand, I did use it to win back his girlfriend, so maybe we're even.
Don't know how he's going to use it. He's got no amp, he's got no cables, no power.
Crime rate falls to new low. Yeah, because it's a police state. Good old regular Dad. I wonder if I'll ever see him again.
I have a feeling that Biff's behind me. Oh no.
Jen? Hey, Jennifer!
Tap on the glass, idiot.
I gotta get her attention.
It's not like it's space and there's a vacuum. Maybe Dad can help.
Dad!
How can I help, son?
Could you let me talk to Jennifer?
Jennifer Parker?
Yeah, she's in the room next door.
Let's see, that'd be waiting room beta. Got it.
You're all patched in, son. Jennifer!
Martin, is that you? Where are you?
I'm over here, in the camera.
Oh, Martin, aren't you in enough trouble already?
Trouble? Jen, what are you talking about?
You know, with all the drinking and the PDAs.
Jennifer, what's wrong with you? You sound strange.
I used to be strange, Martin. But thanks to my First Citizen Plus treatment, I'm well on my way to becoming an average, well-adjusted teenager.
Citizen Plus? Oh no, Jen, not you too. Why's your door open?
Now that I'm finished with my Citizen Plus treatment, I'm free to go whenever I want. I'm just waiting for the nice guard to escort me out.
Hey, on your way out, do you think you could help me break out of here?
Oh, I couldn't do that, Martin. It's against the rules.
We couldn't break the rules now, could we? How is that guard not hear this? The door's open.
Okay, forget breaking out. Could you at least come visit me? It's kind of lonely in here.
I don't think it's a good idea for us to see each other until you've undergone your First Citizen Plus treatment.
Why not?
Because your gosh dang hormones are out of control, Martin.
Okay, conjugal visits are out of the question then.
Jen, snap out of it. This isn't the real you. I mean, it's kind of like the real you, but not like the real you in this timeline.
Wow, that's...
I know, it sounds crazy.
I'd never call you crazy, Martin. You're just sick. I should know, I used to be sick too. But now, I never want to spray paint a Buick or listen to rock music ever again.
Hey, do you know what time it is?
No.
Time.
Didn't they give you some kind of digital watch when you were done with all that brainwashing?
The Citizen Plus watch? I won't get one of those for another 5 or 6 treatments.
Rats.
Damn, they're hard to get.
How'd you wind up in the Citizen Plus program anyway?
My dad signed me up, and it's a good thing, too. I was completely out of control.
I kinda liked it. Jen, this whole Citizen Plus thing is a scam. Edna's using it to take control of everyone in Hill Valley, including her husband.
You know, Citizen Edna told me you were having paranoid delusions, but I had no idea.
So, what was your Citizen Plus treatment like anyway?
Well, that's weird. I don't really remember. Must be a side effect of the treatments.
Well, at least they didn't play Mozart.
Could you hang around for a few minutes? It's nice to have someone to talk to.
I'll be here until the guard comes for me. Then I'll really have to tell him about how you're hijacking the cameras.
Oh, come on. Don't be a narc.
I'm not a narc. I'm a good citizen.
dad carpal tunnel. Okay, let's look at our options. We have a guitar, which we can't use because there's no amp. Maybe we can bribe the guard with a newspaper. Nah, that'll never work.
Hey, let me out!
Okay, apparently there is a vacuum in there.
Doc! Dad!
How can I help, son?
See what I see?
Stay close, Dad.
I'm as close as I can get, Martin.
Dad!
Right there.
How can I help, son?
Stay close, Dad.
I'm as close as I can get, Martin.
It's a long shot. Wait, didn't Marty have like a little wireless jack?
Okay, Jane, here's a little something I think you're gonna like. At least, I hope you still do.
Martin?
Jennifer!
Oh, Martin!
Oh, it's got her moist.
Martin?
You're too darn loud, Martin.
What are you doing?
What's going on here?
I have no idea, sir. I was minding my own business when all of a sudden a horrible noise started coming out of that camera.
Well, that's not right.
Yeah, well, neither is this! No one scrambles my brain, you hear me? No one! I'm Jennifer Parker, rock and roller.
Jen?
Oh, yeah, right.
What's happening?
Yeah! Jen!
No time for small talk, McFly. We need to get you disguised so we can walk out of here. Calvin Klein underwear? Really?
There. How do I look?
A little short for a stormtrooper, but it'll have to do. Come on!
No way. Jinx. She was thinking exactly what I was thinking. I see she is a girl of culture, too.
I can't plug my guitar into that.
Okay, Hotshot, what's next?
Now we rescue Citizen Brown, get the hell out of here, and get things back to the way they're supposed to be.
Whatever, just as long as I get to break some stuff. I've got a lot of pent-up hostility right now, you know?
Miss Parker.
What the?
Yeah!
I'm here to escort you to the lobby. Your father's waiting for you.
Can he wait? I was hoping that this attractive young man could take me on a tour of the facilities.
I'm afraid I really must insist, miss.
Relax, Jennifer. I've got everything under control.
Really?
Really.
Okay, then. But first...
What was that for?
For saving me, dummy. Let's go, officer.
You know, I'm probably gonna have to write you up for a PDA violation.
Don't bite me.
What?
Rock and roll.
Oh, is she gonna... Oh, that's right, we're in disguise. Alright, let's see what we got down here. A massive speaker set up. I think it was Beethoven that was playing in A Clockwork Orange, not Mozart.
don't know what kind of movies they're showing Doc, but I don't think he's enjoying them.
It's Clockwork Orange.
I used to think she was a little annoying, but now she's just plain evil.
You can say it, Marty. Starts with a C. She's a cow. We don't want to go this way yet.
That looks like a giant air freshener. Weird.
Actually, it looks like something different.
I guess that thing pumps smells into the Citizen Plus helmet.
That thing on his head kind of looks like his old mind-reading device.
I've seen that helmet somewhere before, but it never did that.
It didn't work.
Jeez, he looks miserable. That speaker looks really familiar.
How
no improvement, Citizen Edna. Shall I recycle the treatment?
Very well. Increase the overall stimulation levels by a factor of 1.21 kilocarls and start again.
1.21 kilocarls? I can imagine Carl, but 1.21 of them? Tab. I wonder if he's playing Robotron.
Do you mind? I'm trying to run a complete personality rebuild on the big man himself here.
And?
And the last thing I need is your stubby little fingers turning Hill Valley's savior into a drooling rutabaga.
Is there a problem over there, citizen?
No problem, ma'am.
Good. Let's get back to it.
Oh.
All right, let's see if we can find some... hang on. I picked up his accent.
Can I have some of that? Feels like I haven't eaten in years.
No, that's tannins. He's not allowed to eat it until he's taken his pacification pill. We tried to give it to him an hour ago, but he still hasn't swallowed it.
Let me try. I can be pretty persuasive.
No.
Thought they would have outlawed
Don't
plastic drinking straws.
It'll all be over soon.
How do we kill the guard?
Hey!
Shh! Busy!
Don't tell me to shush! Maybe we can hit him over the head with a guitar.
I don't feel like serenading anyone right now.
Ooh! A crack under the door.
Looks like a little crack between the door and the floor.
Must be Robert Downey Jr.'s cell.
Wow, they've really got this door locked up tight. I wonder what sick freak they've got in here.
That's a
I should have known.
Is he crying or laughing?
I almost feel sorry for the poor guy. Almost.
Oh, he wants to play rock, scissors, paper.
Hi, Biff. Looks like your intercom's busted. Just as well. It'd probably be just a bunch of swearing and mixed metaphors anyway. You want out of here, big guy? Guess they don't work.
Ha.
Hey, yes, Biff. Sir. Guess who your guard is? Peekaboo!
What? He has a pill?
The guard says I'm not supposed to give you any food until you swallow your pill.
Biff doesn't swallow.
Oh!
Oh, wait a minute. That old trick where you got a key on the other side of the door? One of those old metal keys? Old style? You drop it onto the floor by pushing it from the other side onto a piece of newspaper.
Hi, Biff. Come on, Biff, just swallow your pill.
It's lucky it landed on it.
Oh, Biff spit.
Corona.
No, no.
Oh, this is so obvious.
Hey, is that a public display of affection over there?
Wait.
What? Sorry, it was just a shadow. Stop goofing around and get back to work.
Yes, sir.
All these bad accents are making me nervous.
It made a gun holster noise when he picked it up.
Jeez, what have they been feeding Biff? Horse tranquilizers?
Probably. Teabag him.
Yo, God!
Who, yes. Me? I mean, me?
Yes, you. As you can see, that slacker of a technician is sleeping on the job again.
What?
Please be a dear and tend to the Citizen Plus control panel, will you?
Sure.
Okay, Doc, I'm sleeping. In. Now, how do I get you out of here without turning you into a vegetable?
What are you doing over there, Citizen?
Jeez, where's the off button on this thing? Hey, an equalizer. At least, I think it's an equalizer.
Well, let's have a look at our options here. Volume, tactile, don't know what that is. Gastrosensory?
Oh!
That thing?
Olfactory. I think I know what that means.
I don't. It's a fart dispenser. Yeah.
What the?
Looks like the aroma tanks have clogged themselves again.
Oh, thank you. I hadn't noticed that. Come on, make yourself useful. I'm sorry about the delay, dear. This'd go a lot easier if you just gave up this madness about time machines and altering the past. You should concentrate on the future.
There is no future for us.
You won't think that in a few more hours.
Anna, please,
out of the room.
Think about the consequences of your actions.
Me? You're the one threat.
She had to wait. Till I went to the room to start talking again. Testing.
Check.
1, 2.
Sibilance. Oh. Sibilance.
What was that?
Nothing. Maybe we can play the guitar into here. Oh, yes, the speakers.
Did you hear something?
No, ma'am.
Must be really deaf.
I could have sworn I heard some of that rock and or roll music.
Huh. It needs more volume.
Rock and
Where's Martin?
Or roll. Where
Don't
have I heard
worry,
that from?
Dear. After we're done repairing your damaged mind, we'll fix young
rock
Mr. McFly, too.
Is that a Simpsons reference? Rock and or roll. I know that reference. I'm just gonna sit here and think about that for a moment. Rock and or roll. I'll figure it out. Look at this.
Doc's not going anywhere until I pump up the volume.
When did I lose control?
Oh, dearest. You never had control. That's why you needed me in the first place.
was a volume one here. Somewhere.
Volume. Finally, a word I can understand. Okay, that moved him a few inches. Maybe I can blast him right out the door.
You'll never get away with this.
I've gotten away with this for years, Emmett. You've just been too distracted by the little gadgets and gizmos I've thrown your way to notice.
Ah. It was that episode of The Simpsons where the Garden of Eden in church by Iron Butterfly. Wait a minute. This sounds like rock and or roll.
What was that? You! What are you doing?
Get my friend out of here, you nutcase. Okay, that was a little less dramatic than I had expected.
Whoa! Big buddy, put the guitar in your pocket and run!
No, Your Honor.
What? I can't hear you!
You're welcome!
After him, you slackers!
The hell is she covered in?
Attention, citizens. This is an Omega-1 priority alert.
Aliasing in the background.
Potentially disruptive nonconformists are loose in the courthouse. Please return to your homes until the situation has been resolved. Have a nice day.
Doc's in the poo bin.
What do we do now?
Now we wait for the glass to clear out so we can make a break for your time machine.
Hey, it's my mom. Hey.
Don't talk to her. She could give us away.
Where is the DeLorean anyway?
I had the wreck towed to my secret lab near Clayton Ravine.
Clayton Ravine? As in Clara Clayton?
Why is that significant?
Well, Clara's kind of supposed to be your wife, so yeah.
Fascinating.
Shouldn't we go help?
Once we go back and change history, none of this will ever happen.
I guess.
She just three-stooged them. Yeah, Doc had a secret lab in the comics. That's where he kept the second DeLorean, but in the comics he rebuilt one. So I don't know whether this Back to the Future is connected to those comics. Probably not.
What the heck was Edna doing to you back there?
She was trying to rebuild my personality from the ground up. Erasing the parts she didn't like.
Harsh.
Hey, you get your damn hands off her.
All right, Dad. No offense, Your Honor, but why'd you marry Edna anyway? She's kind of crazy.
Yes, now. But back when we were first dating, her madness was tempered by an ironclad sense of right and wrong. At least, that's how it seemed to me at the time.
Deja vu.
Mom, Dad, no!
They'll be fine. Once we repair the time stream, none of this will ever have happened.
I guess you're right.
Looks like the coast is clear.
Why didn't they lose tunes their
Let's
way
go fix the DeLorean.
The
I'm afraid I'll have to do that without you, Martin.
What? Why?
Well, from what little I understand of time travel, if you help me rebuild the time machine, your presence in the repair efforts could cause some sort of temporal paradox after we return to 1931.
So what am I supposed to do? Just hang out here in Bizarro Hill Valley until you fix the time machine?
Exactly. But don't worry. If things work out according to plan, you won't even notice I'm gone.
You know, for a second there, you sounded almost as confusing as the real Doc.
See? We're making progress already. See you soon, Martin.
Good luck, Your Honor.
Oh, and you might want to stay off the streets for a few seconds.
Stay off the street? Citizen Brown? Emmett?
What if someone else didn't hear that? What if they're walking across the road right now?
He's not coming back, you know.
What the?
What are you talking about?
Emmett, without me to guide him, he's almost useless. Before I found him, he was a miserable failure who never finished anything. But with me to inspire him, look at what we've built!
Yeah, it looks crap.
Yeah, you've inspired him, all right. Inspired him to turn Hill Valley into a bunch of uptight dorks.
I wouldn't expect a delinquent like you to understand.
You think you've inspired Doc? I'll have you know that without you, Emmett Brown is destined to build a time-traveling DeLorean and a flying time train.
Preposterous. Emmett couldn't even build a dog feeder without me to guide him.
Yeah, well, he did that, too.
Yeah, and it failed miserably.
Not the only inspiration in Doc's life, you know. In my timeline, he married one of the sweetest women of the 19th century.
Sweetness. Blech. Emmett needs discipline to stay focused. He's so easily distracted.
Okay, Your Honor. Starting to get a little concerned here.
It worked! Ha ha! 1 second I'm in the present, the next I'm 6 months in the past! Amazing!
6 months? It took you 6 months to repair the time machine?
6 months, my family fortune, and a sketchy deal with a gang of Libyan nationals. But it was all worth it for this moment. Ha ha!
Emmett, don't do this! You need help!
Oh, blow it out of your exhaust, poor dear. Now that I've escaped into the past, your pack of divorce lawyers can't... Martin, how long have you been waiting for me?
A couple of minutes, maybe?
That's curious. I set the repair time circuits to arrive only a couple of seconds after I left. Oh, well, I'm sure there's no need for concern. It's probably just a minor miscalibration of the time circuits. Here.
What's this?
Clothes for our trip. We can't have you traipsing around 1931 in that ridiculous outfit.
Wait, our trip?
You didn't think I was going to let you erase the worst mistake of my life without my help, did you?
Fine! Leave!
Well, this time circuit being made in Japan...
I'm with you, Emmett!
Nothing to do with being bad, because all the best
I
stuff
run
is
this
made
town.
In Japan. Everybody knows that. No, that time circuit's a major problem.
Time circuit set for August 26, 1931. You ready to go, Your Honor?
Call me, Doc.
How does he know there's not going to be an oncoming car in the future? All the past.
This is where I last saw him. You, teenage you. You were headed this way, arm in arm with Edna.
Ugh, luckily my erstwhile wife was never the type to kiss on a first date. If we work fast and stay focused, we can see to it that our relationship never moves beyond the hand-holding stage. Well, will you look at that? The old town theater.
What about it?
I haven't thought about this place in years. The missus made me tear it down back in 71. Said the movies were corrupting the younger generation. It was all nonsense, of course. I spent countless evenings here in my youth, and it never turned me into a hoodlum. Say, remember Public Enemy? Why, you dirty rat. No good yellow-bellied stool. Never did manage to see Frankenstein, though.
Come go see it now.
But you're going to. That's what we're here for, remember?
Right, of course. The film that was supposed to set off a chain reaction in my imagination, inspiring me with a notion that would launch my scientific career.
You've still got no memory of what that notion was?
Well, how could I? It happened in the brain of a different Emmett Brown. An Emmett Brown now erased by the shifting sands of time. Luckily for us, I do know something about my own brain, having lived in it for the past 70-plus years. Once we get my younger self re-inspired by that movie, nothing will distract him from his proper... Great Scott, will you look at that?
The town square?
It's just like I remember it, only dirtier. Oh, the old courthouse.
Come on now, Doc, you need to... Go inside and check it out. First rule of time travel, Doc... Never allow your other self to catch sight of you. It could cause reality to collapse or something.
You mean...
Never bang your
right
mom.
Behind you. Don't peek. Go on. I'll let you know when you're gone. And don't forget, you're Carl Sagan.
The billions and billions guy?
The suspected arsonist.
Huh?
Just go with it.
Well, let's have a look around here. Really? What up, Doc?
Harry! You do show up at the oddest moments. Where have you been hiding?
Let's go with that one.
Oh, you know, here and there, you're a little hard to pin down yourself. I went looking for you last night, but...
I believe I was off entertaining a beautiful lady. You know, I never really got a chance to thank you.
Well, I'm sure you would have escaped Kid on your own.
Kid? Oh, sure, I'm grateful for that, but no, I'm talking about Edna. It's funny to think of now, but until that crisis, I actually thought Edna and I disliked one another. Imagine!
Oh, sorry, I was distracted by the fact that notepads were a ridiculous 25 cents. Can't tell him that.
Yeah, well, girls are great and all, but don't get carried away. The thing is, you shouldn't let Edna distract you from, you know, the business at hand. Finishing your project for the expo and going to see Frankenstein.
Oh, pshaw. I'm far too busy for movies these days.
But,
And as for my project, it's practically done.
The rocket car?
The rocket car? Boy, are you out of date. I've junked a rocket car.
But...
More trouble than it's worth. I'll never figure out a propulsion system that does what I want it to do. And besides, its social utility is practically non-existent.
Yeah, they'll never have hoverboards in the future. Epiphany? Or an epiphatree?
You'll figure it out, Emmett. You only need a bolt of inspiration, that's all. Maybe if you went to a...
The mental alignment meter is a much more worthy project.
The what?
It was Edna's idea, and she's really been cracking the whip to get me to complete it in time for the expo.
Emmett, I'm a little confused here. What day is it?
Why, it's opening day. The opening day of the expo. Which reminds me, I'd better skedaddle back to the lab. If Edna catches me dawdling, there'll be heck to pay. Catch you around, Callahan.
October 12th. Doc?
It's those damn time circuits.
Come to think of it, it is a bit brisk for August.
Oh, we're 2 months late. The expo's about to start, and teenage you is already in over his head with Edna.
I always did have a tendency to plunge into things.
Let's plunge into the DeLorean and get to the right date.
No, it's far too risky. Remember how I was late picking you up in 86?
Yeah?
That should have been a tip-off. Something is horribly wrong with the time circuits. And the problem appears to be getting worse. If we try to jump now, we could find ourselves stranded in the Cenozoic Age. Or worse, the Mesozoic.
Then we're stuck?
For the time being, I'll look into the problem and see what I can do. In the meantime, you can go to work on the other problem.
Right. I'll go to the lab and see if I can talk teenage you out of...
Impossible. If young me is already as infatuated as you say, you're not going to be able to talk him out of anything. Believe me, I remember. Better to focus on the more clear-headed half of the couple.
Edna? Where can I find her?
Where do you think? I'll drive. The DeLorean should still function adequately as a means of conveyance in the first three dimensions.
Well, I don't think he's going to be able to do much for the time circuits, because I think the transistor was invented in 1947. So, you ain't going to get much repair parts at a Radio Shack. I know that guy.
You were right. There she is.
My soon-to-be ex-future wife is nothing if not predictable.
Do I really have to talk to her? I mean, couldn't I just hang out until you fix the time circuits and...
Oh!
I'll talk to her. You'd better get the DeLorean out of sight before someone...
Hey, you! Quit blocking the drive!
Hey, it's this guy!
All Car of the Future contestants need to report to the North Tent!
Why not?
Doesn't he remember me?
Good luck!
So, how's Eunice? So they think that this car is one of those mad inventions of the 30s, Buck Rogers style. Didn't they have the first World's Fair in New York in 31?
Come see the Cars of the Future, brought to you by Statler DeSoto.
Hey, man. How's Eunice?
Hey, excuse me?
Yeah?
When does the expo
open?
Not till
tonight. Anybody without official business here, please get off the grounds! You got official business here?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, stay out of the way of the workers.
Workers?
You look familiar. Do I know you?
Yes, you do.
Nope.
What was that? Look at that. The roses disappear. Truck here.
It's not as nice as my truck back in 86. Jeez, I hope I still have a truck back in 86.
What was that? Oh, it's a tree. I'd rather talk to Arthur.
Hey, Artie! Officer!
Officer?
Right. Don't blow your cover.
Will you please keep your mind on the task at hand?
Can't talk right now.
Spell it B-R-O-W-N. It's not exactly an obscure name.
That's not how you spell it.
I still don't see it on the list. I'm sorry.
Oh, for the love... Let me try this one more time. This is the Hill Valley Science Expo, right?
First annual.
Indeed. The purpose of our fair is to showcase cutting-edge technology.
That's right. And to burnish Hill Valley's reputation as a forward-thinking community.
And yet, you want to exclude the maker of the most revolutionary breakthrough of all.
It's not that I want to, but... Oh, dear.
Mr. Callahan, you do pop up at the oddest times. What are you doing here?
Well, they're probably all going to be the same.
I need to...
Whatever it is, I hope you don't have to deal with Mr. Stonewall here. His sole function seems to be preventing people from accomplishing their business. Honestly, with him keeping the books, it's a wonder the Tannen gang got as far as they did. Have you seen Emmett?
Which one?
No.
Then you've heard all about his big breakthrough, the mental alignment meter. Isn't it exciting? And to think, he didn't even realize the import of his discovery until I pointed it out to him.
Whoa, did you see that?
Anyone like him, so oblivious to his own potential.
I kind of wanted to talk to you about Emmett and his potential.
Funny, I didn't spot it myself at first. In fact, for the longest time, I thought I didn't even like him.
Yeah.
Yeah, her arm, when she swung it up, left her right arm, it swung right through her body and went out her back.
I don't get it. I mean, Emmett's nice and all, but he's not exactly the kind of guy that has girls swarming all over him.
Well, I'm not your average girl.
Yeah, but...
I appreciate your concerns, Mr. Callahan, but I can take care of myself. I know what I'm looking for in a man, and it so happens Emmett fits the bill to a T. That's Emmett Brown. Rhymes with clown, which I'm beginning to think you are.
Just a simple mix-up, I'm sure.
I've no doubt of that.
I'm not sure if I've learned everything I can from Edna.
I was still going to talk to her then.
Ahem. You said that Emmett fits your bill of requirements for a man.
Yes.
What would that list be, exactly?
You'd make a good reporter, Mr. Callahan. You know that? Well, his physical appearance, for one thing. Emmett may not be Clark Gable, but he cleans up surprisingly well. I gave him my grandfather's white suit to wear at the expo. Oh, you should see him in it. He looks positively radiant.
Looks good in a suit. Got it.
And he's completely devoted to me. That's important. I've got no time or tolerance for playboys.
Faithful as a Labrador. Check.
Thirdly, and most important...
Yes?
Well, his mind, of course. It's brilliant, and it's virtuous through and through. His own mind map shows him to be a model citizen.
Good brain, I see. And if it turned out that you were mistaken about any of these qualities...
Say, what's your game?
Just curious, just trying to understand the female mind.
Well, understand this. I'm not some faint-hearted girl who'd run away at the first hint of trouble. I've made a big investment in Emmett. Not money, but I've sunk all my ambitions into him.
I'd
have to be thoroughly disillusioned before I'd call it quits with Emmett. Got it?
Uh-huh.
Now, Mr. Cub Reporter, is there anything else?
This is one of the list of things Doc Brown wanted to do with the time machine, was to find out the biggest mysteries of the universe. Women.
What the heck is this mental alignment meter of Emmett's?
Oh, it's an absolutely revolutionary invention! Measures a person's affinities, what he's attracted to, what he's repulsed by, that sort of thing.
Interesting. And it really works?
Well, of course! What's the point of inventing something that doesn't work? Or, anyway, it works well enough for my purposes.
So you say Emmett only has eyes for you?
Absolutely. It's almost embarrassing how devoted he is to me.
Well, it's good to hear he's finally settling down.
Yes. Settling down?
You know, ready to stop playing the field, as it were.
Playing the... Oh, you're joking!
But I can't help feeling sorry for him.
Who?
All of Emmett's other girls, now that he's with you.
Please, I think I know Emmett by now. There are no other girls.
I wonder what's going to happen to Emmett's little black book.
Little black book?
Oh, it's legendary. That's what enabled Emmett to become the, Valentino of Hill Valley High. Gee, I wonder if he'd let me have it.
You must think I'm pretty gullible, Mr. Callahan.
You say you know Emmett as a model citizen, but you don't know him as well as I do. Did you know he once cheated some Libyans out of plutonium?
Plutonium? What would Libyans want with plutonium? I'm sure he had a very good reason. Emmett's mind map demonstrates conclusively his brain is oriented toward virtue.
This one time, to power one of his science experiments, Emmett hijacked a train.
Please, there hasn't been a train hijacking in Hill Valley since the days of Mad Dog Tannen.
Duh.
Emmett's done a lot of shady things in his time. My vice principal warned me to stay away from him.
Your vice principal sounds like a dolt.
He's your brother, you dumbass.
Rather hard for me to picture Emmett as a chick magnet.
Chick magnet?
A guy who gets the girls, you know, motors running.
Motors?
Moist.
Who makes them, you know.
You mean a chic?
Yeah.
Well, it's a matter of taste, I suppose, but when he's properly pomaded and decked out in my grandfather's white suit, Emmett just glows. Makes my heart flutter a bit just to picture him.
Pomaded. I think that means hair slicked back.
That's all the questions I got.
Very well, then.
Hey, Audie. You seen my Oreoli?
You mean this?
Yeah, Oreoli.
Thanks.
Like to see her.
She
Aureoli's
gets to come and go freely, and I'm forced to wait. I love it.
Alright, so what I can gather is we're gonna make Emmett look bad so she won't like him anymore.
Ah, good. You're back. Give me the full report.
She says she likes you because you've got a virtuous mind, you look good in a suit, and you're completely faithful to her.
Damn, she's got me dead to rights. Well, you'll just have to find a way to change her mind. I'll be here if you need any help. Do you need any help?
Any idea what your teenage self is doing right now?
Unless I miss my guess, he's in the garage frantically working on his latest invention and cursing because he can't quite get it to work. Damn.
So he's obviously over at Riverside Drive.
Edna doesn't seem to care much for Trixie Trotter.
She never could get past the fact that Trixie had been Kid Tannen's ma.
I think I'm starting to get a plan.
Good. Tell me. No! After all, it's my history we're talking about. If I learn how you're planning on altering it, my resolve may weaken.
Have you figured out what's wrong with the time circuits?
Not sure. Possibly. It seems to me to be a simple wiring issue, but I'm double-checking to make sure. All the basic equipment appears to be functional.
Any chance I could borrow the DeLorean? I want to drop in on young you at the lab.
Well, I don't know. Time circuits.
Listen, I promise, I won't take it to 88.
Even so, I'm worried about letting it out of my sight while it's still behaving unpredictably. Tell you what, I'll take it on a test drive 1 minute into the past. If it passes the test, I'll let you borrow it.
You're not taking the Kingswood.
It worked! Didn't it?
I'm afraid not. In fact, the discrepancy appears to be getting worse. I arrived 6 hours ago.
Oh, too bad.
I didn't want to risk undoing any of the work you've done thus far, so I kept out of sight. But the time lag wasn't entirely a waste. I stopped by the hardware store and bought the parts for a chronometric analyzer.
A what?
A diagnostic device. See, I plug it into the time circuits and set them to cycle. When the green light goes off, I should have the data I'll need to understand the scope of the problem.
Hey, no driving the exhibits off the lot!
Looks like you'll have to find another set of wheels if you want to get to the lab.
How the hell did he get that to sit on the console? I'm pretty sure that the gear stick was right next to the time circuit's control switch. Because Marty hit it accidentally when he was driving in the car park at the Twin Pines Mall.
To all who approach these hallowed halls, I bid thee welcome. To all who approach these hallowed halls, I bid thee welcome. To all who... Oh, hiya, kid. Say, aren't you the fellow who...
Got you to turn on Kid Tannen? You bet.
You look younger without your mustache. That was a dirty trick, you know, making me think Kid had gone and iced Artie.
I'm sorry, but it was the only way I could...
Forget about it. I'm trying to. Yesterday's in the past. That's my motto. You gotta live for today.
Right.
So what are you doing down here anyway? Do you wish to pull the levers that control the future? At the expo, silly. Technology for a better tomorrow and all that.
Oh, yeah, that's actually why I'm here.
You should totally tap that, mate.
So who are you supposed to be?
Don't you know you're Homer? I am Techni Muse of Progress. You can tell by the lightning bolts.
Must have slept through that class.
I'm supposed to be a goddess-like. I'm the one who inspires all the great men who make the discoveries. And women, too. Leave us not forget Madame Curie.
I never would. So you work for the expo?
Yeah, ain't it a kick? I greet all the important guests. And on the final day, I get to bestow the golden sundial on the winning contestant.
Madame Curie died of radiation poisoning.
Listen, I've got a proposal for you. I have this friend, right?
No dice. I'm only seeing Artie now.
It's not like that. See, my friend's in a relationship with Edna Strickland.
Oh, poor schmuck. I wouldn't wish her on anyone.
Then you see where I'm coming from. He won't listen to reason, but I thought she might call it off if she thought he and you were, you know.
You are an evil imp, ain't ya?
Sometimes a guy's gotta resort to underhanded tricks. What do you say?
Sorry.
Ah.
Edna might be a pill, but if I play dirty tricks on every dame who disapproves of me, well, I'd play a lot of dirty tricks. Besides, such stunts are beneath the dignity of Techni Muse of Progress.
So, Artie's working for the expo too, huh?
Oh, Artie's doing swell! The papers made a big deal of him testifying against Kid. People have been beating down his door ever since the trial. The expo's darn lucky they could get him.
What's Artie's job?
Oh, he's a real high muckety-muck at the expo. He's in charge of all the money and the hiring and firing.
Hey, not bad.
You're telling me, and super respectable, too. It's a real relief for him to have a job where the boss never pulls a gun on him.
It's good to see that you and Artie are both doing okay.
We're more than okay. And if things keep going the way they're going, we may be more than just friends before you know it.
Well, don't get too serious too fast.
Nah, we're keeping things casual, for now.
Good. I'm sure Grandma will appreciate that.
Marty's really gonna affect his own future if he's gonna make Artie into a, you know, more of a brave person, because behavior reflects onto their offspring. So George McFly might no longer be a wimp, which would mean that Marty would have no reason to change his ways in 1955, which could cause a time paradox.
How's Kid's trial going?
Slowly. You know what they say. The wheels of justice grind slowly, but infinitely fine.
Except in Hill Valley, where they don't move at all.
What?
Nothing. It's just, you know, something I heard once. So no regrets about turning him in?
None at all. I should have known better than to take up with him in the first place. But what can I say? I was dumb. I let myself get taken in by his charm.
Charm? Whose idea was it to put a science and technology expo in Hill Valley?
Beats me. Artie says it's all bread and circuses. But I ain't seen a single clown yet today.
Techni, Muse of Progress. Not a bad gig.
Artie got it for me. It's my entree into respectability.
See you, Trixie.
From this chamber of wonders, we bid you a fond adieu.
Goodbye. this looks like something you'd see at a world's fair.
The century looks bright for our fair metropolis. Jump with us 50 years into the future for a peek at Hill Valley circa 1981, courtesy of Hal's Hardware and the collective imagination of mankind. Could
it's
this
so
be
accurate.
Our venerable town square? Yes, indeed. Though the form looks strange and new, the function remains the same as ever. But where are all the people? Why, they're underground. A network of burrows extends a mile into the earth, giving future Hill Valley's 10 million citizens plenty of space to work, play, and raise their families.
So where do they get their vitamin D from? Sounds pretty dumb to me.
Of course, our residents will want to venture forth into the fresh air occasionally. And what better excursion than a pleasure ride in this elevated super train of tomorrow? Agricultural advances will make it a breeze to feed our burgeoning population. Tired of waiting for Mother Nature to do her job? Just press a button. Presto! An artificial rainstorm drenches the valley's thirsty crops.
Now that is accurate. If you remember in 2015, the weather service was actually a thing. Too bad the postal service wasn't as good.
And after the rain, what else? An artificial rainbow, reassuring all the good people of Hill Valley that their needs are taken care of, and life is sweet.
It sure is.
Pleasant dreams, Hill Valley. And the Expo would like to remind you that you can find everything you need to transform your dreams into reality at Hal's Hardware. Hal's Hardware, serving our fair city since 1895.
More stuff here. Whoops.
Nice rock. But I can't reach it.
Oh, I know how to reach it.
And after the rain, what else? An artificial rainbow, reassuring all the good people of Hill Valley that their needs are taken care of.
Nice rock.
And life is
sweet. But I can't
sweet.
Reach it.
Apparently we can't reach it.
Of course, our residents will want to venture forth into the fresh air occasionally. Looks bright and for our better excursion than a pleasure ride in this valley. Will make it a breeze into the future for our population. Hill Valley, tired of waiting for Mother Nature to do her job. Hardware and the collective imagination of mankind. Presto! Could an artificial rainstorm drenches the valley's thirsty crops? Yes, indeed. Though the form looks strange and new, the function remains the same as ever. But where are all the people? Why, they're underground. A network of burrows extends a mile into the earth, giving future Hill Valley's 10 million citizens plenty of space to work, play, and raise their families.
Oh.
My future wouldn't be built so shoddily.
Hi, Miss Strickland. I was just...
Break what you like, Mr. Callahan. It's no skin off my nose. Just keep away from Emmett's booth. Speaking of whom, I'd better go see what's keeping him.
I'll go check on him for you. I was just heading there anyway.
No, you weren't. The last thing he needs is another distraction at the 11th hour.
But...
Tut tut! Not another word. I've got the rest of the day all mapped out.
Miss Strickland!
I'm sorry, I don't recognize you. Heavens, you shaved off your hair, but... Carl Sagan?
I'd like a word with you, if I may.
I'm not sure it would be seemly for me to be seen in the company of an alleged arsonist.
I think it may be in your best interest. You see, I know what you're up to.
Let's go somewhere where we can talk privately.
Go! I'll keep her occupied till you get back.
What do you think he said to her? Hey, wait a minute, we got a skateboard. Which predates the one Marty invented in 1955.
The underside of this future train model looks familiar. I wonder if it can ollie. If you squint, it almost kind of looks like a big diamond.
It looks like a diamond without squinting.
I still got some work to do.
We've got to destroy the suit. We've got to make him appear like he's cheating. Maybe Trixie can help with that. And a model citizen, well, if we screw up that test... Look at the glitching.
Hang on, Emmett. Hope you're ready for a big breakup.
Skitching.
Emmett?
What the hell?
Thanks again for your assistance, Detective Parker.
Detective? What the hell is Kid doing here?
Nothing criminal, I assure you. I was just getting a mind map of Mr. Tannen for our exhibition at the Expo. The authorities wouldn't allow Edna and I to stage a demonstration of the mental alignment meter with a violent felon, but this little baby is just as good. Okay, let's see now what's next. Check the stew, sort the maps. Ooh, I almost forgot that.
Edna really is cracking the whip, isn't she?
Well, yes, but she's got my best interests at heart. Without her, I can get so distracted. Did she send you down here to check up on me?
Yeah, she wanted to come herself, but...
She's busy too, I know. Well, you're a poor substitute for Edna's lovely features, but make yourself at home.
Thanks.
No thanks are necessary. Without you, I'd never be where I am now. In love with a woman of my dreams, and a mere 6 hours from my first public triumph as a scientist. Wait a minute. 6 hours? Jumping Jehoshaphat, I'm running out of time!
Peabody Farms. Well, we've got a lot of stuff to play with here.
I'd be careful of that if I were you.
Why?
Well, the rocket fuel experiment must have stripped one of the teeth in the hand crank. As a consequence, if you turn it for more than 10 seconds, it...
Whoa!
Sends out an electric shock.
Oh! That made him angry. That could come in handy.
Hey, Emmett, what's cooking?
That's an old Brown family recipe for Hassenpfeffer.
Hassenpfeffer?
Rabbit stew. The trick is to add the cumin an hour after the carrots. Take a whiff. Isn't that just about the best thing you've ever smelled in your life?
It's, powerful, yeah.
I've got it on a slow boil for later.
Okay, so that makes him good. Oh, should I push it?
How does the mental alignment thing work?
Here, I'll show you.
Hey!
The test subject wears this mind-mapping helmet, which probes the brain by measuring fluctuations in skin conductance and electrical resistance on the surface of the parietal lobe.
Uh-huh.
Yep, got it.
When I turn on the mind-mapping helmet with this radio switch, the subject is exposed to a series of visual stimuli, intended to provoke a series of positive or negative responses, as indicated by these lights on the helmet.
Hey, is that...
As the responses are recorded, they're relayed to this special typewriter, which prints out a punch card that represents the subject's mind map.
All I see is a bunch of holes.
Well, to you, maybe. But to our mental alignment meter, this mind map is nothing less than a peek into your subconscious. Observe as I place your mind map into the MAM.
Layabout. Is that machine calling me a slacker?
No, your own physiological responses did.
Okay, I figured it out already. The mental alignment meter that he's wearing can be adjusted with these... What's this?
What's this?
That's a can of used motor oil, rocket fuel waste, and assorted chemical sludge left over from my abandoned rocket car.
Gross.
Accounting doesn't enter into it, but it is disgusting. Would you mind disposing of it on your way out?
Sure.
Yeah, I'll just put it in my pocket.
Phew.
Ugh, did the clamp fall off again?
Yeah.
Put it back on. Oh, I don't even know why I keep that bacteria tank around. Every time the clamp falls off the nitrogen tube, it takes a couple of minutes before I can get the stench out of the air. Whew.
Hey, could we watch Frankenstein on this?
Sorry, Harry, but I need this projector to trigger positive and negative visual stimuli for my mental alignment tests. Besides, a movie like Frankenstein should really be watched on a big screen, don't you think?
The mind of a degenerate criminal.
It's Kid Tannen's mind map, as captured by our mind map helmet.
You could tell he's a criminal just by looking at this?
No, but when it's fed into the mental alignment meter...
Weird.
Weird nothing. It's science!
Science! What, so can we swap that with his?
I don't care by Trixie Trotter.
Edna doesn't approve of that sort of music, but I find it very soothing. Oh.
Try and figure this out. You start the test, and then stimuli is shown. And what you see is reflected onto the helmet. So if it's something you like, it glows green. If it's something you hate, it will glow red. Each result is put onto a card. So, maybe if we simulate the feelings with these devices here, we can change the outcome. Okay, I think I have it now. No, we want it to bad.
Ew!
Ew!
How do we advance it, though? This. Who's the man? John Wilkes Booth. That's the man that assassinated Abraham Lincoln. So hang on.
Yes, it's already stinky enough in here.
Oh, it takes a few minutes for that to go away. We need to make that good, so... What's this? Easel. The food.
Ah, that smells much better.
We can't have it all there.
Careful, don't let all the flavor escape.
Okay, I've got this now. So he has good feelings about the bad guy, so let's record that. A copper. Well, we don't want him feeling good about the copper. Let's use this one instead.
Ow!
That wasn't 10 seconds.
Ow!
Who's that? Tannen. Mad Dog Tannen? Or is that? Good.
I guess it needs time to get boiling again.
Oh, so we can't use it more than once. We'll have to use the I don't care.
Ah, that's the stuff.
That's Vice Principal Strickland. Cross-dressing. Remember, it was in Edna's apartment. Innocent-looking child, so we want him to feel bad about it? We've got to wait for that record to stop.
Don't turn it off! This is my favorite part.
How's it playing? The needle hasn't moved. Records that old don't go that long.
Ow!
I am my own superintendent. My star is on the ascendant. change back? On the light that we want anyway, don't we? Because if that's a hot chick, that's Trixie. We definitely want to put that thing on now.
Hey, Emmett, I think your mind map test is broken.
Oh, well, that switch just keeps shorting out on me. No time to fix it now. I'll have to take care of it at the expo.
Looks like I'm not going to be doing any more mind maps. I guess I'll test this out and hope for the best.
It's transparent. All right, so obviously what we did was correct.
I wonder how this new mind map for Emmett turned out. Ugh, I hope this stuff doesn't get stains all over my guitar.
I think we can throw that at his suit. Oh yeah.
Bingo! Now Emmett's mind map is as bad as Tannen's. Now all I have to do is swap this out with Emmett's original mind map and Emmett's own machine will do him in.
Why don't you talk a bit louder, Marty? Doc's just literally standing there. Why don't we just switch them in the first place?
Okay, Emmett. Get ready to meet the new you.
Hey!
What?
I almost left behind my mind map card. We're gonna show it off at the expo as a rare example of a model citizen. Edna'd kill me if I forgot that.
She might kill you anyway when she gets a look at that mind map. Once Emmett gets to the expo, I'll try to figure out how to get him to put his card in the mental alignment meter. But for now, I better concentrate on making Emmett a slob who cheats on his girlfriend.
Well, let's throw that oil at him. That is her grandfather's suit, after all.
Hey, Emmett, I've got a... Whoa!
Oh, no!
Whoops.
What the heck?
Oh, jeez, I'm sorry. Your suit's ruined. Edna's gonna be royally PO'd.
Wrong!
What?
When Edna gave me this suit, I realized that the probability of me keeping it clean was infinitesimally remote, so I spent a few hours whipping up this.
What?
Whoa! No. What was that?
A chemical compound capable of wiping the grime off any surface.
Damn it, you'll make a fortune.
Not anytime soon, I'm afraid. Due to an inherent instability in its molecular makeup, after 12 hours, the cleanser's component chemicals break down into a series of cloth-shredding enzymes, rendering it unsuitable for commercial use.
Wait a minute. Does that mean your suit's gonna dissolve in 12 hours?
Hey, gods, no. The solution dissipates into the air after it's applied. But it does mean that after this batch of cleanser ages another 11 hours and 53 minutes, it would eat away this suit faster than 1,000 starving moths. And that would be a crisis of unimaginable proportions.
Why?
Because this suit belongs to Edna's grandfather, who wore it on his wedding day. Poor guy was gunned down just a few years later.
Emmett?
Well, enough wool gathering. Back to work.
Okay. Wait a minute. Wasn't the DeLorean's time circuits malfunctioning?
I don't want to get that covered in any messy oil.
I just had a thought. Maybe that solution could be aged artificially, but it doesn't look like I could pick it up. Alright, what were we doing?
Now we're getting somewhere.
Faithfulness. Well, Trixie's going to take care of that, if we can convince her. And the suit. What was that other thing?
What's this?
It's the placard we'll be putting in front of our booth at the expo.
The scientist that caught Kid Tannen?
A small exaggeration, but Edna says it'll attract investors. What do you think of the picture?
You look a little...
constipated.
Constipated.
What? Edna said I looked intense.
Yeah, intensely focused on taking it.
I get the picture. I'll have to find a better one. Unfortunately, there's a lot to choose from.
Heavy.
Extremely. Mother has been rather obsessive about photographically cataloging my life.
If only we were clever enough to write dates on those photos. Solve a lot of problems.
Hey, Emmett, I've got an idea.
What?
Why don't I take your photo album over to Edna so she can pick out your new picture?
That's a great idea. She's got a better eye for these things than I do anyway. Thanks, pal.
Don't mention it.
Maybe we can swap the picture for something that makes him look bad.
Emmett says this album has pictures of him all the way back to when he was a baby.
Vaughn Brown. They used to be the Vaughn Browns until the father changed it during the First World War. What can I use that for?
Now we're getting somewhere. What?
I was just thinking about the future. All that talk about Edna's grandfather made me realize something.
Please let it be something about lightning.
Life can be short, sometimes brutally so. So why not seize the day and grab your happiness while you can?
I'm not sure I like where this is going.
I was saving this for next Valentine's Day, but why should I? I know what I want.
Emmett, no.
I'm gonna ask Edna to marry me. Right now.
No.
Oh, right. I'll wait until tonight at the expo. It'll be much more romantic that way. Just think. By this time tomorrow, Edna and I will be engaged and will be the toast of the scientific community. And I owe it all to you.
You're welcome. Hey, Emmett, I've got to go out for a while.
I thought Edna sent you to make sure I wasn't getting distracted.
Oh, you'll be fine.
Good thing that truck was going by. Hey, the tent's open.
That volcano looks a lot like the one I did for my 7th grade science fair. Press button to experience Hill Valley's primeval past. Okay, if this dinosaur is called a Tannenosaurus, I'm gonna... Well, whew.
It's funny you should say that. In the comics, when Tannen stole the DeLorean in 2015... to go and give himself the almanac, he couldn't get the time circuit to work, so he smacked it with his cane, which is what caused it to malfunction. But he actually ended up in the Jurassic period, and he knocked out a velociraptor with his cane, and he needed fuel, so I think he stuffed the tail of the dinosaur inside Mr. Fusion. But yeah, he almost got killed by a dinosaur.
Maybe when Real Doc comes back, we'll take a trip to see a dinosaur.
Yeah, nah, you better not.
Furs donated by Lamont's House of Ermine. At least they're going to a good cause.
Yoink.
They're stuck tight in this tar.
Times may be hard in Hill Valley, but our present worries fade into insignificance when we ponder our Pleistocene past. Is the wolf knocking at your door? Be glad he's not a Tyrannosaurus, king of the ancient lizards. And if you find yourself drowning in debt, well, you could be drowning in something a whole lot stickier, like the Hill Valley Tar Pits. This peek into the distant past is brought to you by Lamont's House of Ermine, reminding you fur is forever.
There's something a little off about the scale of that model.
To all who approach these hallowed halls. What's cooking?
Ideas. Up here. See ya, Trixie.
Don't be a stranger.
Oh, we can talk to him now.
Hey, Artie.
Hey, Mr. G-Man. How's the, undercover operation?
If everything goes as planned, we should be wrapping things up real soon now.
Well, when it's time for me to play my part, just say the word.
What's the word? Everybody heard about the bird.
So you're the registration guy for the expo?
And chief accountant and paymaster.
Hey, you're coming up in the world.
And none of it would have happened if I hadn't responded to that subpoena.
Has he got PayPal?
You haven't met Sylvia yet, have you?
My contact person? Not yet. Is he or she at the expo?
I don't think so, and I'm pretty sure it'll be a she.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's a she.
I like Trixie's new outfit.
Cost the expo $14.89, but it was worth every penny. After all, she's the public face of the expo. Techne, muse of progress.
Did you tell me that dress costs more than a cult peacemaker?
I don't suppose you miss working for Kit Tannen.
No sirree, Bob. I don't know how I ever got mixed up with an abusive, gun-toting thug like that. He even stiffed me on overtime pay.
Giggity.
Think the Hill Valley Expo will be a success?
I don't see why not. Why shouldn't California have its own high technology center?
Keep doing what you're doing, Grandpa.
Grandpa?
Whoa!
That's our, code name for you.
Oh, ha! Funny.
Like that time he called George Dad, Dad, Daddy-o.
Can I talk to you a minute, Miss Strickland?
Surely. Excuse us a moment.
It's like this. I found out about Trixie Trotter.
Yes?
Apparently they made her some sort of queen of the festival. Techne, the muse of progress.
They didn't. Well, they said this expo would give Hill Valley a reputation. I didn't realize this is what they meant.
What have you got against Trixie?
It's the idea of it. Allowing our city to be represented by a woman like that. I won't stand for it. As a socially conscious citizen, I demand you discharge that muse.
Trixie? What's wrong with her?
Oh, she's hardly qualified for an honorific post at a public event.
Look, lady, she fits the costume, she's an American citizen, and she managed to memorize all her lines. What more qualifications do you want?
Oh, these people are impossible.
Why do you want to get Trixie fired?
One simply can't allow women like that to attain positions of respect in society. It creates a very bad precedent for the future.
Does it?
But try telling it to this poor sap. She's got him completely steamrolled. That's how they operate.
Is it?
Still, I could get her discharged if I had the goods on her. No doubt a woman like that has left a trail of scandal, and I'd find it if I were still a reporter. But I haven't got time to do the legwork now. I'm too busy with Emmett and his invention.
So if we get her fired, then Trixie might actually help us.
So you wouldn't hesitate to get Trixie fired from her job?
Hey, if I had the goods on her. She's obviously got her employer completely bamboozled. The only way to snap him out of his spell would be to show him something really shocking.
That's all the questions I got.
Very well, then.
You spotted Cubal.
Hey, pal.
Oh, geez, this guy again.
Why is his teeth
funny?
Great?
I was gonna say the same thing.
I think he's glitched.
Shouldn't you be in jail with the rest of Kid's gang?
I was, but then an opportunity availed itself and I...
sang like a canary.
I prefer to think of it as exhibiting an admirable sense of self-preservation.
Will you be playing piano for Trixie later?
Nah.
Why not?
Because Little Miss Goody Two-Shoes thinks she's too respectable for Cubal these days.
These days.
You seem kind of angry about Trixie.
Angry? Listen, kid, me and Trixie go way back. I know stuff about her that even Kid doesn't know. Stuff that curls your socks.
Looking at
really?
His teeth.
Oh, yeah. And now to see her flouncing around the place, making like her stink don't smell, it just cheeses me off, you know?
Must be a model error.
So what's so, toe-curling about Trixie's past?
Yeah, like I'm gonna tell you.
Oh, come on.
No.
Tell you what, I'll tell you something embarrassing about me first.
Like what?
Oh, this should be good. Oh, yes. That one's gold.
Well, under the influence of alcohol, my mom made a pass at me.
Ooh. All right, Junior, you win. That was pretty embarrassing. Almost as embarrassing as this.
Is that Trixie?
And a moose.
Yep.
She's not wearing much.
No kidding. She did a lot of these artistic postcards a few years ago. I got a whole set of them.
Can I, have one?
I don't know. You ain't gonna do nothing bad with it, are you?
Hey, I promise. I'll only use it for the greater good.
Well, okay.
Why is it stuck together? Ew. Okay, I think we got our thing that will get Trixie fired.
Have you heard from Kid lately?
We're not exactly on speaking terms these days, on account of our varying degrees of incarceration.
What kind of stuff have they got you hauling here?
How the heck would I know? Electro this, robo that, dynamo the other. It's all Greek to me.
Hey, what's with your teeth?
Oh.
My teeth?
Yeah, they're okay. Green.
I don't know what you're talking about.
So it's not a glitch.
Seriously, man, what's going on with your teeth?
It's nothing. Nothing. I Oh, crap.
What's wrong?
It's these.
Dr. Frinkle's algae cakes?
Yeah.
A crate of them fell off the truck while I was unloading it, and I just can't stop eating them. How was I to know they'd turn my teeth green?
Well, the algae part might have been a clue.
Please don't rat me out to Audie, okay? I really need this job.
No problem, but you better let me keep the cakes.
Sure thing, pal.
Hang loose, pal.
You talk funny, mister.
I wonder if we can get this guy's teeth green. I hate him.
How about an algae cake?
Yes, I am feeling a bit peckish. Where the hell'd you get that crap?
The expo.
Let's offer everybody a cake.
How about an algae cake?
Much obliged. That was different.
Yeah, it turned his teeth green, but not his.
How about an algae cake?
Don't mind if I do.
Nom, 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 nom.
Bad. Algae, you say? I'm going to suggest that they add that to the menu at the orphanage.
Well, let's not create a time paradox. We'll give these to old Doc first.
How about an algae cake?
Yeah, that tastes exactly like the sludge that Edna was pumping into me back in the Citizen Plus ward.
Where else can we give these to? Trixie.
How about an algae cake?
One doesn't normally think of algae as a dessert item, but, what the hell? Well, it's got a very, unique flavor.
Okay, everybody gets one. What about you, York?
How about an algae cake?
No thanks. I'm trying to cut down.
Okay, so you can offer it to everybody. Let's go give young Emmett one.
How's it hanging, Emmett?
No time for small talk. I've got machines to tune and mind maps to sort.
How about an algae cake?
Hey, Emmett, need a snack?
Desperately. What is it?
Some sort of algae cake. It's supposed to be nutritious.
Oh, I've heard of these.
I want to try one now. Oh,
they better be really nutritious.
Oh, it affects his thoughts. I just wanted to do it again.
Emmett?
What?
Yeah, your jacket's got a little,
Oh, no worries.
Maybe we can use it all up. Oh, wait, we gotta go and give that to Edna.
Hey, Emmett, got a sec?
Why, yes. In fact, I've got several.
How are things between you and your father? I'm kind of surprised he hasn't torn down your lab yet.
Well, he's still angry with me and threatening to cut me out of his will, but I'm hoping that the civic potential of my mental alignment meter will win him over.
It's all right. If he cuts you out of the will, you can burn his mansion down. You're gonna do that anyway.
You can't marry Edna.
Why not?
She's a bitch.
You're too young to get married.
Nonsense. Back in the old country, a man my age already have two kids and a farm. Besides, what's the use of waiting when you're in love?
There's someone better out there. Trust me.
I know you mean well, but look at me. I'm an awkward teenager with poor social skills and a predilection for prattling on about obscure scientific minutiae. Frankly, it's a miracle that one woman has found me desirable. It could be decades before another one comes along.
Many, many decades, Doc.
I just don't think Edna will make you happy in the long run.
Well, she makes me happy now, and that's what counts. And as for the future, well, the future isn't written yet.
You better hope it isn't.
If only Michael J. Fox knew about his future.
Let's just drop it.
Fine.
What do you say we take a break for a couple of hours and go see a movie?
A couple of hours?
Actually, it may be more like 70 minutes.
I haven't got a couple of hours. I still got all these mind maps to sort, and the MAM's wiring is still giving me fits, and...
I get it, you're busy. So, you and Edna, how serious are you guys?
Well, we both enjoy a good joke every now and then, but I'd say on the whole we're fairly serious people. Why do you ask?
No. What I mean is, how serious is your relationship?
Oh, well, as a scientist, I can't state this with 100% confidence, but I'm provisionally certain that I'm head over heels in love.
Really? With Edna?
What can I say? She's my muse. In the week since we've been courting, she's given me so many wonderful ideas.
So he likes a hole.
Are you sure Edna's the right woman for you?
What do you mean?
Don't you think she's a little... controlling?
Controlling? Edna? No. She's just giving me a little much-needed guidance. Before I met her, I was such a flibbertigibbet, always getting distracted by the slightest stray idea. But now, thanks to Edna, I stay focused on the task in front of me, like a narrow-band stream of stimulated photon emissions. Focused!
Yeah, each question we ask is taking his focus away.
Isn't she a little... cold?
Don't let the schoolmarm exterior fool you, buddy. Edna's got enough warmth to raise a liter of water from 0 to 100 degrees centigrade. Know what I mean?
I kinda wish I didn't.
Why is he using a metric system?
I don't know. I just think Edna might be a little dangerous.
Oh, I agree.
You do?
Like all independent women, she's a danger to the patriarchal status quo. That's one of the things I love about her. She shakes things up.
You have no idea. I just think you should be careful, that's all.
Thanks for the concern, but I'll be fine.
You look busy. Why don't we talk later?
Sure thing.
It would be funny to put the oil inside the cleaning. Oi. Why is it doing that? No, stop moving!
I don't want to get that covered in any messy oil.
No.
That cleanser doesn't seem very portable.
It isn't, but this is.
Perfume bottle?
Yes. No. I mean, yes, it's a perfume bottle, but inside is a concentrated dose of my all-purpose cleanser. With a little luck, this should last me through the next 12 hours before its component chemicals break down into a series of cloth-destroying enzymes.
Clever.
Wait. That is clever. I know what to do.
Yoink. What the hell is that?
What?
Wait, why didn't he point the
Sorry,
other way?
I thought I saw a tarantula.
He pointed that way. His peripheral vision should have seen that. He should have gone, well, what's that over there? Time circuits malfunction. So, if we sneak this into the DeLorean,
it'll be safe in there. Hey, Doc. I mean, Mr. Sagan.
Excuse me a moment, Miss Strickland. I've got her neutralized for the moment. How's the plan proceeding on your end?
About that gizmo you've got hooked up to the DeLorean?
The chronometric analyzer?
Yeah, what am I supposed to look for again?
A signal that it's done evaluating the time circuits. The analysis can take a while. Be sure to let me know when the light turns green, and I'll take her out for another test run.
Oh, we were supposed to look at that.
Doc said to tell him when the light on his diagnostic thingy went green.
Nope.
No green light yet.
Okay.
Nope.
No green light yet.
Oh, where is Edna?
Trixie sure got some nice, antlers. This is definitely something Edna wouldn't approve of.
Nice chick.
You might want to take a look at this.
Why in the world would I be interested in... Oh, what have we here?
Oh, sir! Mr. McFly!
Yeah, you left a fire.
It appears your muse has been inspiring more than progress.
Trixie?
Oh, no, no, no. What are you doing with a dirty postcard?
What is she doing in a dirty postcard? I swear, Mr. McFly, if that doesn't convince you that Trixie Trotter is unfit to represent Hill Valley...
I don't need you to lecture me about who I can or can't hire, Miss Strickland. Trixie's darn good at what she does. I don't care if she was once the winsome wench of Winnipeg. Her past doesn't matter to...
Where's Winnipeg?
Trixie?
What is it, Audie?
You know I don't like to pry, but what state did you grow up in?
Province, Manitoba. Why?
Not even an American.
See, darling, the charter specifically states that the Expo's hostess must be a U.S. citizen, so if you're really a Canadian...
What? I'm being fired? You are firing me?
I don't want to.
Here... Take it back.
Well, I'm glad somebody's listening to reason.
Michael J. Fox is Canadian. So is John Candy.
Let's talk.
Oh yeah, now we're getting somewhere.
Trixie?
I'll do it! I'll make that blue-nosed bitty eat her heart out!
That's great! I got it all planned out. When Emmett shows
up... we gotta do it my way.
Huh?
I'm no good with improvising, and I ain't gonna memorize no lines. But I was in this play once. The Parlourmaid's Predicament. I figure I could lift a scene from that.
Okay.
Only, I need a few props.
Why am I not surprised?
Some furs, a big diamond. It doesn't have to be real, understand?
That makes it easier.
And something from this friend of yours, Emmett. Has he got a photo album?
I don't know. Probably.
Better bring it to me.
Furs, a diamond, and Emmett's photo album. And then?
Sit back and watch the fur fly.
Huh. Well, what was it? Furs, photo, and a diamond. Photo album. We've got that.
I brought Emmett's photo album like you asked.
Let's see. Gee, he's not bad looking. In an egghead kind of way.
Remember, I don't want you seducing him for real.
I ain't a cradle robber, kiddo. How about the furs and the diamond?
I'll get him to you.
We got a diamond looking one. If we squint, it looks like a diamond.
Voila!
Say, pretty snazzy for a phony rock. Gimme. Keep that up and I may take a real shine to ya.
I'd rather you take a fake shine to Emmett.
I'm working on it. Now bring me those furs, and we'll be in business.
There was a fur on this dude.
They're stuck tight in this tar.
Tar? That spray. We need that spray back.
Amit's formula. Still as good as new. Never know when I might need to get some sticky substances out of some clothes.
Or fur.
It's a good thing I did this before Emmett's 12-hour time limit, where the cleanser might have dissolved the fur.
Aha.
Let's slip out of those furs, shall we? If Jen and I ever strike it big, we're never wrapping these things around our necks.
Good for you, Marty.
Hey, Trixie. Are these furs good enough?
Well, they're a little ratty, but, they'll work.
So, you got everything you need for your big scene?
Everything except for your friend.
Emmett Brown, redheaded guy about yay high. He'll be the one with Edna Strickland.
Not for long, he won't.
Great.
Redhead people usually don't lose their hair color, so how the hell did it get white? Light on?
Hey, the light's green. That means Doc could take the DeLorean out again. I need to talk to you.
Excuse me, my dear. Yes?
About that gizmo you've got hooked up to the DeLorean?
The chronometric analyzer?
Yeah, the light's gone green.
Wonderful. If the systems check out, I should be able to take it for another test run. I've got to run a short errand, Miss Strickland. I suggest you think about what I've been saying.
Oh, I will.
The hell's he telling her?
When did you land this time?
9 hours and 37 minutes ago.
Ouch.
Frankly, it started to get a little difficult to avoid running into myself. Still, the time jump yielded some interesting new data on the flux field. I'll run some more tests and we'll see what we find.
How many hours was it before that stuff went? Was it 6?
Doc's trip aged the formula a few hours. Not enough to turn it to acid, though.
Oh, so we gotta keep going, okay. I'm surprised you didn't even notice that. Wait.
Nope. No green light yet. Hi, Artie.
Go on. Call me Grandpa.
Huh? Right. So, Grandpa... Why'd you have to go and fire Trixie?
You think I wanted to? It's illegal for me to knowingly hire a Canadian for the job, and I don't want to be in trouble with the law again.
What? It's racist.
That's all for now.
Over and out.
Grandpa.
Hey, the light's green. I need to talk to you.
Excuse me, my dear.
Not at all, Mr. Sagan. Take your time.
Much obliged, Miss Strickland. Yes?
Your chronometer's gone green again.
Excellent. Let's hope this time my test run is a success. I'm sorry to desert you again.
Yes, well, you've left me with plenty to think about.
Any luck this time?
Depends what you mean by luck. My arrival time was off again.
By how much?
8 hours this time. Gave me the chance to take in 3 showings of Frankenstein. Good movie. A bit implausible from a scientific perspective, but I can see how my younger self would have been mesmerized.
What about the DeLorean?
Oh, yes. I did get one critical piece of information. The chromium elements in my circuits became unstable during the temporal shift. I should replace them with titanium.
Great!
Now, unfortunately, titanium won't become commercially available till the Kroll process is perfected in 9 years.
9 years?
But there may be another solution. I'm going to fire up the chronometric analyzer again. Then, while I'm storing it there, you can... Uh-oh. Where did it go?
The lab!
You better get down there before she makes the situation impossible. I'll tend to the DeLorean.
Okay, 2 things. Why did it make the re-entry sound?
Age to perfection.
If he arrived hours ago. And why can't he just make titanium?
Hey, Emmett, I'm back.
Oh, crap.
Oh, my.
You know, I thought you were coming down here to keep Emmett focused on his invention.
Oh, she is. But she's generously scheduled brief canoodling breaks every 45 minutes to keep my mind fresh.
Time's up, dear. Let's get back to work.
Shall we?
Now, Mr. Callahan, what can I do for you?
Get the FMI.
Mr. Sagan says he needs to talk to you back at the high school.
He does. Whatever for.
He says he wants to give you an interview about his invention.
One of those tedious cars of the future? That can wait. I've got to keep Emmett focused on his invention.
He wants to give you the scoop about his thrilling escape from Kid Tannen.
That's yesterday's news. Our invention will be tomorrow's story.
He literally just told 2 wrong answers. Don't you think that he's lying?
He says he's got a lead on the speakeasy arsonist.
He does he? Well, I'm not sure anyone cares about that old story anymore. But what? I suppose I could spare a few minutes in the service of solving a crime. Will you be all right without me, sweetheart?
It'll be tough, but I think I'll muddle through.
Try to keep him focused. He's so easily distracted.
Don't I wish?
I think she's the speakeasy arsonist. Alright, so what do we...
There it is. I've been looking all over for my portable anti-stick anti-stain formula. Where'd you find it?
Out by the trash.
That's strange. I haven't been out there for hours. Oh well.
Are you gonna spray your jacket? It's looking a little dusty.
Not until it's really dirty. This cleanser doesn't grow on trees, you know. Well, some of the ingredients grow on trees, but the rest are synthesized polycarbonate
really
detergent blends.
I can do that. I'll wait until you're at the expo to show Edna what a suit-destroying slob you can be.
Well, that's about it.
It is?
Yep. As soon as I get all this stuff loaded into the truck, I'll be ready for the expo. Wanna lend me a hand?
How about I go tell Edna you're coming? I'll, get her ready for you to pop the question.
Good thinking. Go on ahead. I'll meet you there.
I really hope this works.
party!
Doc!
Those wheels wouldn't survive that long. They used to be made of ceramic, I think.
What's all the hustle and bustle?
It's almost time for the opening ceremony.
Whoa, what happened to his head?
Holy jeez, I better work fast. I think I got it all worked out. When it all comes together, Edna will think you're the worst guy in town. I just need a couple more pieces.
Well, don't go to too much trouble.
What do you mean? Oh! You got the time circuits fixed.
Whoa, look at the background.
Not exactly. You see, I've been mulling things over, and...
it's true.
In the timeline you're from...
The right timeline.
In the trees.
Yes, yes. I've got a wife.
A great wife. Clara, and kids, and a dog, and a bitchin' time train, and...
And Edna? How does her story turn out? How does she end up?
Well, Edna ends up...
Happy? Can we lie to him? Well, he always did say you shouldn't know too much about the future.
You're not really supposed to know these things in advance. It's bad luck.
But you told me how my story turns out.
Yeah, but...
It's not as if I'll be in a position to do anything about it once my younger counterpart's destiny has shifted. I imagine I'll be folded into the new timeline, and I'll probably lose all memory of the old one.
Maybe.
So tell me, just to satisfy my curiosity, what's going to become of Edna?
Oh, this is gonna turn out good, isn't it?
She's doing great. She's got a full life, lots of friends, always busy.
She's got a fellow?
Sure, lots of them.
Lots of them? She's a tramp?
No. What I meant to say was...
Let's start over. How does Edna end up?
To be honest, she ends up kinda sad.
Sad?
She lives with some cats in a dinky little apartment, and she spends most of her time yelling out her window at people, and collecting newspapers, and living in the past.
I see. Perhaps we've been going about this problem the wrong way. Do we really have to completely obliterate my timeline so we can restore yours?
Yes.
Doc?
Maybe we could have the best of both worlds. I could be with Edna, but it could be a little bit, you know, more healthy.
Can you hear yourself? Do you know what you're saying? Let me remind you. It was her influence that led you to take over Hill Valley and turn it into this nightmare state.
Come now. It wasn't as bad as all that. The crime rate was low, and the uniforms were nice.
I don't believe this!
All I'm saying is, let's stop and take a breath. This elaborate plan to derail my younger self's love life, is the short-term misery worth the long-term gain? Maybe we could find a third way. One where everybody wins. What do you think?
There's only one right answer.
No! I'm sorry, Doc. I can't go along with what you're saying. You don't belong with Edna.
So you're determined to break us up, in spite of my stated wishes?
Basically, yeah.
Then there's nothing left to say.
Fine.
Where are you going?
Why should it matter to you? Aren't you planning on overriding me?
I do it, Doc. What are you doing, Doc? get him with the oil. Oops. Achoo.
Hey, Emmett, what's keeping you?
Oh, hello, Harry. I guess I've got a mild case of stage fright. I'm about to play my big scene, you know? No telling how Edna's gonna react.
You've, got something on your suit.
Don't tell him. Have.
He wouldn't have noticed.
Anti-stain formula, work your magic.
It's gonna eat it.
Emmett!
Just in the nick of time. Step back now. We're gonna need a little space here.
Oh, aren't you a vision? Like something that descended from the heavens.
Yes, I'm feeling a bit elevated at the moment. There's something I've just gotta ask
you. Wait, your tie's a bit crooked.
I've been holding it inside for weeks now, and I've simply gotta get it off my chest.
Oh.
Error.
Uh-oh.
My grandfather's suit!
My formula!
Oh.
Look! Turn your head! I'll be right back, and we can try this all over again.
And it's Lethrop Brown!
Huh?
Trixie Trotter? How do you know this woman?
I don't! I mean, I listened to some of her records, and I may have taken a picture or two of her, but I...
Go
She's
on!
She's Canadian.
Deny to the world that you know me. Perhaps it is true, but I know you all too well.
What is going on here?
You She's rich boys acting. Are all alike. You think material possessions can compensate for a broken heart? Well, you can take back your furs and take back this gaudy diamond,
Ouch.
Too! I don't need your expensive presents. I need you. And more importantly, little Emmett Jr. needs you.
Well.
Edna, I...
Don't Edna me. Apparently you are not the man I took you for.
But I am, see?
Here it comes.
The mental alignment meter proves it. I am the man you fell in love with.
Let me see that card.
It went yellow for Trixie.
I should have known. A degenerate criminal.
What?
Get out of my sight! I never want to see you again!
That was rough, Emmett. I'm sorry you had to go through it, but things are gonna be okay. You and me can... Emmett?
That went off great, huh?
Yeah. Maybe too great. Damn it!
How did he not trip over those tram lines?
Damn it!
Go away!
Come on! Where are you? I'm sorry you had to go through that scene at the expo. Things didn't work out the way you expected, but everything's gonna turn out okay. See, I know how this story turns out, and...
What the... Is he on the roof?
The story is over.
Do a flip! Let's get logical here.
Stay there, Emmett! Don't throw away your future!
I don't have any future.
Wait, the dog.
They say I'm crazy, got no sense, but I don't care. They may or may not mean offense, but I don't care.
Weren't there panthers
Stop!
Up there?
What are you doing up here?
Don't jump!
I wasn't gonna jump!
Then what do you-
This is where I come when I wanna think.
Oh.
When I want to be alone.
Oh.
Oh, well, I'll just go then. Carry on.
Well, don't let me bother you. Go ahead and think.
Can't you take a hint? I don't want you here. I don't need you.
You don't know what you need.
And you do?
As a matter of fact, yeah. You need...
That one's pretty punny.
To give your system a jolt, take in a thriller like Frankenstein.
Frankenstein. I tell you that my very life force is drained away, and you want to talk about Hollywood monster movies.
It's a very inspirational monster movie.
It's 70 minutes
especially
long.
The scene where they bring the monster to life. There's this big gurney that lifts him up into the air, and see, there's this wild storm going on, and lightning crashing everywhere. It's amazing. And you just gotta see it, Emmett. It'll change your life.
Look at my helmet. Which light is flashing?
Yellow.
Apathy. I don't care about movies. I don't care about anything anymore. And I never will.
Don't give me that. You care.
I think I preferred young Frankenstein. Put the candle back.
You still care about inventing things.
Inventing is overrated. 99% hype, 10% fraud. Name one invention that ever did anybody any good.
How about...
I've always despised Edison. Telephone.
The telephone? Think how that invention has revolutionized the whole world.
Yes, now a person can be rejected long distance.
They do it by Facebook now.
The automobile was a great invention, right? You love cars.
Yes. If I'm lucky, I may be struck by one today.
Think about Edison and the light bulb. That was a great invention.
Yeah, might have been. If there was anything in this miserable world worth illuminating.
Did he actually invent it? I'm pretty sure he had a whole team of scientists working for him.
Help me out here.
You're getting on my nerves, Callahan. At least you would be if I still cared about anything.
Me! You care about me, Doc.
You?
Yeah.
You did this to me.
Did what?
I was perfectly content drudging away in my dad's law office. You show up out of nowhere, get me all excited about inventing, and disappear. 2 months later, you show up again, you trick me into making a hero out of myself and getting involved with Edna Strickland. Then you appear a third time and pretend to be my friend just so you can yank the rug out from under me and send me sprawling into the dirt.
Okay, I can work with that.
I loathe you, Harry Callahan! Or is that even your real name?
Nope, it isn't. I'm Batman.
Marty! My name is Marty.
Oh, so everything you've told me has been a lie.
More or less.
Why? Why did you ruin my life?
You suck. Let's annoy him.
I did it for fun.
You ruined my life for fun?
Yeah, that's how I get my kicks.
You bastard. And all that time you spent building up my dreams, telling me I was gonna be a great scientist.
Let's annoy him.
Yeah, what a laugh. Dreams are only for people with guts enough to follow them.
You're saying I don't have guts?
You? Look at you.
What do you know? A person like you? You don't know the first thing about me. I have more dreams in my little finger than you'll ever have.
Hey, daydreams don't count.
Daydreams? That's what they said to Edison. That's what they said to Einstein. That's what they said to...
Dr. Frankenstein?
Yeah, and look what they accomplished. I'm sick of people telling me what I can and can't do. First my father, then Edna, now you! Listen to me, good. From now on, I'm living my life my way. I'm taking my own advice, and I'm following my own ideas. My ideas. Do you hear me?
Reverse
my ideas. It's Scott. I've
so
got it.
Got what?
The solution.
He
my invention. I know how to make it work.
Mental alignment meter?
No. My airborne personal transport device.
The rocket car?
Not rockets at all. That was my mistake. The basic idea was sound, but the propulsion system was unworkable. But the lightning! Suddenly the answer is clear. It came to me all at once, like Like
a bolt of lightning?
Exactly! Static electricity! Super ionized static electricity powering the asynchronous oscillation of frictionless plates inside the... What's this stupid thing doing on my head?
Emmett! You're you again!
Here, I've been wasting my time with silly mind-reading tricks when there's serious science to be done. And the expo begins at 8!
Let's get the hell out of here before anything else happens!
What?
I said, let's get out of here before anything...
Ledge is really poorly made. So how's it hanging, Doc?
The expo's already started.
Right. Hatch. Bye, Doc. Let's go get a haircut.
Emmett's helmet. I don't think he needs it now.
Oh, I don't know. He's about to die. Might as well take it. This thing, dude.
I can't undo the knot.
Knot.
Should I go for help? Better not leave him. Hey, Emmett!
What?
I guess he can't hear me from down here.
Oh, great.
Hold on!
I wasn't planning on doing anything else!
You're higher than what you were... The distance is greater up here.
Emmett!
What?
I'm sorry I had to get you so upset. See, I figured you needed to...
Forget it! This isn't the time for long-winded explanations.
I'll help you finish your new invention.
Great! The first step is to get me down from here!
Can you climb up?
I'm afraid I can't find a convenient purchase for my upper limbs.
What?
No handhold!
Why can't he just talk properly?
Got anything useful on you?
Only my wallet. Oh, and this portable anti-stick, anti-stain formula. Oops!
Oh, wait.
I'm sorry about you and Edna.
Water over the bridge! Now get me down from here!
Hang in there!
Very funny!
That stuff can eat through the rope. What the
Emmett's
hell?
Solution. This stuff's dangerous.
Alright. We can't undo that knot, so we might as well spray it.
That's not gonna help Emmett. I can't grab it from here.
So we're gonna go up top. Maybe we have to swing across. Whoops.
Hang in there!
I don't have a choice!
You know, if you watch Back to the Future 2, when they're in 2015, you can actually see the damage from the 1955 incident is still on the clock tower. Let's see, I think it broke about here. That's not what I wanted to do. Can I use the digital arrows? I can use the digital arrows.
I still can't reach you.
Maybe you should employ centripetal force.
What?
Ah, gotcha.
Let's get out of here.
Your pants, they're stuck.
Do something before we're crushed.
Oh, the spray.
What are you doing?
Trust me. Hold on.
What did you say your name was again?
Marty.
Marty? Thanks.
Don't mention it.
Tungsten. The catalyst will need to be made out of tungsten, given the temperature within the converter will no doubt be intense. We'll have to harvest the filaments from all the light bulbs in my house.
Your invention? You think you can finish it before the end of the expo?
Think? I've got to. My future depends on it.
Then let's go.
Of course, the oscillating plates will need to be calibrated precisely. Even the slightest misalignment could cause the magnetic field to fluctuate in intensity, leading to sudden shifts in polarity. The results could conceivably be catastrophic.
Who cares?
My thought exactly. Science should be messy and unpredictable, or else where's the fun of it?
I just realized. Doc said the ingredients in that spray, some of it was grown on trees, but the other was synthetic. Doc's
need
allergic to synthetics.
Mr. Sagan, got the kinks worked out of your car of the future?
Not all of them.
Look
at
the toys!
Mundane,
he hasn't got the kinks worked out of these toys. They keep shrinking.
As usual, I have not the slightest idea what you're talking about. In fact, you remind me of someone... someone I used to...
There, there, my dear, don't worry. I'm sure we'll all turn out well in the end.
Maybe for everyone else, but I suddenly feel very much like someone who's going to be alone and unloved for a very long time. Maybe I should get a cat.
Get two.
Nonsense. I can state with nearly 100% certainty that you're going to have a long and fulfilling life.
How can you know that?
I think you'll find I know almost everything worth knowing about you and young Emmett and his friends.
Doc.
Tell me, how much do you know about Harry Callahan?
Doc's an a-hole. Shouldn't it say concluded?
Let me explain it again. I realized that it wasn't Edna that made my life miserable. It was science. She used my science to turn Hill Valley into a police state. If Emmett doesn't go through with a demonstration at the expo, his dreams of being a scientist will dim just enough for Edna to step back into his life and steer him down another path.
Doc.
What's the time? 9:55, 10 p.m., 2.5 hours. 11, 12. I'll have to finish this another night. Games get really glitchy the further you get into the story. So, when I wanted to play this game, I thought I'll play the digital version because I purchased it a couple of years ago. I went to download it. Was unavailable because Telltale Games went out of business and they took the game off the store, so lucky I also bought a physical copy of this. I'm kind of glad I did. It's a really good game. Anyway, I'm going off the air.